So I play a role of faith, gender fluid, I'd say drag performer. And I was drawn to the role because I was actually asked quite last minute, which I think worked in my favour because I was given the opportunity to express elements of my being that I'd say are otherwise stunted, kind of suppressed.
Can you talk a little bit, obviously this is a film very much about an unlikely friendship that develops between your character and Darren's. Can you talk a little bit about your relationship working with him, obviously a very seasoned actor alongside you?
Yeah, no, I'm an amateur compared to Darren, maybe compared to most actors probably. It was great. There's not really much story to it other than we got thrown in and it worked. I think if we didn't get along, it wouldn't have worked. So it was quite fortunate that. He's very inspirational, incredibly hardworking. He's not a diva, full of old stories. And I, on the other hand, full of new stories, definitely a diva and a nightmare to work with.
When you look back at your time on set, I'd imagine there were some quite surreal moments, some quite funny moments. I'm curious if they're ones that make you smile the most when you think back on them now.
Most of the time off on set was spent walking in stilettos. Because there's no excuse, really, to not walk properly in them, because I have friends who will dance, big, muscly boys who will dance incredibly detailed routines in stilettos. So I had there's no sympathy for me. Like, oh, you can't walk down this street. No, no sympathy. So most of the time was spent trying not to break my ankle.
I guess, did you have any apprehension about tackling a story that deals with what for some people is quite a sensitive subject matter in terms of drag, obviously, both within and without of the LGBT community? It provokes reactions, it provokes discussion. Did you feel you had something to say with this role in particular?
You know what, I think the magic of the role genuinely is that it's not really about, it's not so much about identity or really, I mean, it is of course about identity naturally. But I'd say the investigative aspect of the film, the heart of it, isn't really a search for identity. It's more two people's connection via grief and loss and love. And the parts around it with identity play a secondary role, which I think makes the film quite charming, because in that respect, it's quite fallible and, you know, trips over itself and, you know, it's intergenerational.
My final question, what's coming up next for you? Obviously, very busy, lots of different things. What can we look out for next?
Mate, I'm going to, a bit of everything. Anything I can do, literally. I just like creating stuff. So, walking my dog, mostly.
I can't really say a great deal about my involvement because as an actor, I play a part which I think the whole audience is rooting for from the beginning. And whether I turn up or not is probably a massive spoiler. So I think that's something that drew me to the part in the first place because, you know, it's a will she, won't she. But I also did all of the makeup and the design of the makeup with an amazing friend, Mel, who is an amazing makeup artist. But yeah, we did all of the drag looks. And so that was a challenge. So yeah, it was about being challenged in all areas. So I think when it came to totally intergenerational portrayal of drag and what drag means nowadays, we wanted to focus on Jackie being influenced by Greta Garbo, by icons of Hollywood, and he had a very kind of thin eyebrow. He would not have changed his drag look from the beginning of its inception to now. And then Faith is representing a totally different age of drag queen, someone who identifies as non-binary, somebody who is just a person and represents themselves by, you know, wearing the clothes they want to wear and doing the makeup they want to put on their face. And so it was more about just enhancing Jordan's natural beauty when it came to his drag look, because essentially he lives his whole life in drag because he Faith is portraying a totally different person to the world. So it was tricky. It was really tricky.
Within the LGBT community, there's a big discussion about drag and about where the boundaries lie between drag as a performance and as a spectacle and transgenderism. Can you talk a little bit about what, if anything, you think this film has to say about that experience, if it's about drag or if it's about identity beyond just the performance side of it?
I think it's actually just... it's probably a better portrayal of entertainment and entertainment for a community. You know, as an actor myself, I could be classed as a drag act because I dress up as different people. As much as I don't identify within the LGBTQ spectrum, I do feel like anyone could react to my performances in a negative or positive way. And so I think Tucked, what we're trying to say, I guess, is... drag has come a long way, certainly in terms of its portrayal, in terms of how the jokes are used, and essentially drag of old was a man dragging up and diminishing himself by representing a woman. So we've got to the point now where that's actually a part of an identity as opposed to a joke act. And I think the film is cyclical in that nature, and by the time you get to the end, you see the young performer taking the essence of what drag was and making it into something brilliant and remarkable. And I think that's some of the charm of the movie. I actually have a film called Tracks, which we shot back-to-back with Tucked. It was a two-picture deal, and it's a romantic comedy that we shot across Europe, and it's about a couple that go interrailing and the kind of the failings and the positives that can happen when you're in a confine of a train carriage. And that should be coming out sort of... we've done the festival circuits. We premiered at Raindance last year, so that should be looking at being released later this year. And then I just finished a movie called Sideshow with Les Dennis, and it was a brilliant experience. Les plays a tarot card reader, a mind reader who's washed up, and he is doing the coastal towns of the UK, and my character tries to rob him, and hilarity ensues. So they're in post-production on that, so I don't think it will be out this year, but certainly the beginning of next year it will be something to watch.
Basically, it is two human beings who might behave in what people believe is abnormal ways. But basically, they're two humans who are worlds apart, but have needs. And those needs meet, and they react with each other and form a beautiful bond. And I hope that people will realize that being a cross-dresser is something which is not a joke, which is not something that should be laughed at. It is a terrible compulsion that has ruined so many lives. I mean, he adored his wife, and she found out, and she hated him. And yet he loved her to the day he died. And if she could have only accepted that he dressed as a woman, but it didn't affect him as loving her. And I did a film years ago called Victim, which helped to change the law on homosexuality. And I just hope that people might see this film and see that they are really two human beings. You should never put labels on people. Labels are terribly dangerous. And one day, people will look at this and say, they were human beings. Not that he was a cross-dresser, not that she was, you know, queer or anything like that. They were just human beings whose behavior was not the majority. That doesn't mean to say they're wrong. That is, you try to make it beautiful.
It's a film very much about an unlikely but beautiful friendship. Can you talk about that experience for you?
Yeah, absolutely. It was you can't be somebody else. So what you've got in this film, you've got Darren as a drag queen. You've got Darren as a cross-dresser. You've got Darren who likes this young man, Jordan, who wants to take him under his wing, who wants to, you know, look after him, whereas, in fact, Jordan looks after him, which is the beautiful thing of it, you know? That whereas you think that he's looking after Jordan, Jordan is actually looking after him, and that's what's so beautiful.
This film has been described as your swan song, but your final performance on screen. When you look back both at this film and at the entirety of your career, I'm curious what you feel most proud of at this point as an actor and a storyteller.
Well, I think Victim and I think Where Eagles Dare But I mean, I've had so many offers to do more films that I suppose I will have to do it. I mean, I've been running a very big company called New Era, which is one of the leading drama exam boards. So I haven't really been inactive, but I love the screen. I love trying to be real. It's very difficult to present reality. And so maybe I'll do some more.
Final question. You mentioned Where Eagles Dare there, so often voted one of the greatest war films ever made. I'm curious, when you look back at that film now with some distance, what your overriding memory is. I mean, obviously there's a lot of discussion about your accident on set, but obviously it remains one of the finest performances we've ever seen on screen.
Richard Burton drinking four bottles of vodka a day. Basically. But then Brian Hutton, a great director, as Jamie Patterson is a great director. But one knew it was a good movie. And Clint Eastwood. There's only two of us still alive. Yeah, Clint Eastwood and me, which is a bit sad. But the main memory was Burton drinking, really.
So Tucked is, at the heart of it, it's about two drag queens who form this unlikely friendship. Jackie, who is 74, and coming to the end of her career, and Faith, who's 21 and just starting her career. And it's about them finding each other at this very tricky time in their lives, where they kind of are there to support each other through difficult moments. And at the heart of it, it's a movie about friendship, it's about love, it's about family. It's a comedy that deals with very hard-hitting subject matters, but it's this unlikely... It's like a road movie without a road. That's how I like to call it. You know, it's like it's an unlikely friendship tale, and very, very funny.
Can you talk a little bit about your two leads, Jordan, Darren? Because obviously very different ends of the spectrum in terms of the point in their career and lives, but a wonderful pairing.
Oh yeah, so Darren, I've known Darren for years now, and there was literally no one else in the world who could have been my Jackie. You know, it was written for him. He was the only person I thought could do the movie. And Jordan, I've been a fan of Jordan's work for a long time, but I knew him more of as a musician. I loved Rizzle Kicks. I loved what he was doing, and then I saw him do a TV show called Glue, and I just fell in love. His screen presence was insane, and we brought him in. He came into the project a little later than Darren. And they didn't actually meet until they had to film a scene together. But they were both so incredible, and they just brought something so special to the movie. The whole film relies on chemistry, like any movie does. And they had this insane chemistry that just worked from the very first moment. So, yeah.
Even within the LGBT community, there's a lot of debate and discussion about drag and what it represents, what it is, if it is good or bad for that community and the perception of it. Can you talk a little bit about what the film has to say about those kind of issues, that kind of nuance?
Yeah. Well, I think so. The drag scene has changed so much, and that's a big part of the movie, is, you know, Jackie is doing, a dated act, telling jokes that are very non-PC, that aren't very popular anymore, but back in the sort of 80s, 90s, this was a regular drag act that you would see in loads of working men clubs, certainly where I'm from in Brighton. I lived in Spain for a bit as well, on the Costa del Sol. You would kind of see these sort of acts where there wasn't as much effort put into the look, the dress, the makeup and stuff. It was part of it, but it isn't necessarily what it is now. Whereas now the drag scene has changed and the performances have changed, and it's singing, dancing, it's grown into something incredible, but it's with the same aim, which is to entertain. So that was what was so crucial about the movie, is trying to, these are two people that are doing the same thing, but just from different generations, but with the same goal, which was to entertain. So yeah, hopefully it kind of shows that they had their hearts in the right place, and they just both want to do the same thing. But it has grown. Like anything in life, we all have to grow. Everything has to change. A joke that was once funny might not necessarily be funny anymore, but all you do is find a new way of telling that joke. So, yeah.
What are you most hoping an audience overall takes away from the experience of the film?
I hope that they take hope. I hope they're uplifted. I really hope the movie starts just people, a conversation about, be it if it's toxic masculinity, or if it's gender, or if it's drag, or if it's family, or if it's friendship. I think there's a lot of themes in the movie which we touch on. We try not to focus on fully and put labels on things and say, this is this and this is this. That's not what the movie is. But I hope that people watch it and they leave uplifted and kind of just want to talk about the film. I think with any filmmaker will say, you hope people leave wanting to talk about your movie. if someone leaves going, "Ah, it was all right," that's kind of like the worst thing they can say. So, yeah, I hope they like the movie.
Are there any other projects that you're working on, things we should be looking for after this?
Yes, so I've done three movies since this. I did an interrailing comedy called Tracks. I did a lovely little love story with Tallulah Haddon about two young girls in Brighton who fall in love, written by Jeff Murphy, called Justine. And then I just wrapped on a movie called God's Petting You, which is like a weird British true romance, two addicts fall in love and together plan on robbing this huge porn star in Europe. It's very different. And I'm about to start a movie in July called The Kindred, psychological thriller as well. So, busy boy.